course, I was worried about Anna Lou being with the Rolling Stones at the time.
My advice to her in the first place was, don't go on tour with the Rolling Stones.
It was such a seductive opportunity. You know, the world's greatest rock and roll band, they have the highlight, rolling the dice at the top level, and, you know, it was irresistible.
The thing is that the Stones pictures are so gorgeous this time, you know.
The thing is, we should have pictures like that all the time.
Shoot it, for sure, but don't go. I mean, I've got too many friends to go on tour and come back drug addicts.
I didn't know what I was getting myself into. It was unbelievably stupid to pick that group of men in that situation to decide to sort of become part of something.
You know, we're all drugging it up and hanging out. My point was, go on some of it. Don't go on the whole thing at your own peril.
Photographers attached themselves to you. In those days, people didn't, were much more free and easy than they are now. They didn't mind, and no one asked, and no one cared, as long as they got on with everyone. It was like, but, you know, it was okay.
She was one of the first female photographers that I remember. Well, it made a change from another bloke, you know. It was like, this is interesting, see how long she lasts. You know, but she hung in, and that was the other big surprise to me. We thought, she won't last long, you know. Being together every day, day in, week out, she became very unobtrusive, you know. You didn't think anything about Annie walking around going, she'd find things that most people wouldn't get around to, you know.
She was around a lot, you know. She was around socially too, because I remember there's a picture here where I cut myself in a restaurant in Montauk, put my hand through the door accidentally, and then I had to go to the hospital in Southampton to get stitched up, and she was still taking pictures of me, you know, being stitched. My scar's kind of gone away a bit now, but there it is.
Not really, let me see it for a moment. Oh, that one I don't remember. No, I certainly don't remember that one. But that's what I mean, see how she can see things that I can't.
I'm cold, hit and run, rainbow.
After about 10 concerts, you're getting about the same pictures. After about 10 hotel rooms, you're getting about the same pictures. So there wasn't that much new to be gained. And frankly, I thought the situation was very destructive. And I played in the most self-destructive elements in Annie. There's tons of drugs around at that time. It was in their huge drug period.
I did everything you're supposed to do, you know, when you go on tour the Rolling Stones. You know, I mean, just imagine everything you can possibly do, and I did it.
We had a big tussle over a disagreement about her doing that, which I was against.
Also, it was her idea, was it? I never knew whose idea. I thought it was maybe his idea, and he sort of said, you're assigned to this, or something like that. Okay.
But, you know, she got something out of it, and she's got a lifelong friendship with the Stones out of it, and a great reputation, you know, and she's, you know, was the, I guess by this point, just the unquestionably the number one photographer in our rock and roll world.
Have you done it so much that you could go in and blindfold and make cover photos for Rolling Stone and Mick Jagger?
I would never go into anything like you said, like what you just said. I mean, I wouldn't. I really take everything pretty seriously.
She certainly conveyed something from behind the stage or in the pit, and some which had never really been seen before. And the movement that she captured, I thought, was really fantastic.